Dun, 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 dun. Wrong town? Wrong town. It's my kind of town.
Cool.
You okay out here, little guy?
It's okay, little guy. It's okay.
Cool. Science. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah. Cool.
Tour book. See how we're doing here. Done. Done. Man, we are almost there. Don't wait a minute.
All right, so chill in my hotel room. You don't give a shit about that. I gotta get on making this aperture course. Looks like the circus is in town. It's a beautiful sunny day in Hoboken, New Jersey.
Walking over to my hotel in Weehawken.
There's Weehawken over there. Always, and I mean always, wear a life vest. Do-do-do-do.
So, there is a lot of conflicting information out there about breathing. Some people say breathe high, some people say breathe low, some people say breathe in the middle. Don't worry about any of that stuff. You're not really ever going to know exactly what's happening. You're going to be able to feel things, you're going to be aware, but really, it doesn't matter exactly what's happening physiologically as long as you're getting good playing results. So I was reading one time about the Alexander technique, and there was some quote in there by, I can't remember his name. Anyways, the quote was, there's no right position, but there is a right direction. That's a pretty hip lick. What it means, there's no ideal state for anything to be happening in. There's no ideal state for the breath. There's no ideal breath. A single breath that is going to be the best breath for every single situation. But there are certain things that we can do that will give us more productive breathing habits that will help us get the sound that we want, play the way we want to, etc., etc. So, if we buy into this idea that there is no right position, but there are right directions, then how do we find the right direction? First of all, just awareness of your breathing in general, away from the trumpet. We just want to get in touch with the breathing mechanism. Something that I borrowed a while back was from Arnold Jacobs. Arnold Jacobs was a famous tuba player from the Chicago Symphony Orchestra, and he really talked about the breathing and stuff. And one of his main concepts was, don't think about how you're breathing. Don't think about what's happening when you're inhaling and when you're exhaling. Think about moving the air. So the way that I took this, I'm a very visual learner. So what I did was that I imagined that I could see the air around me, like it had some sort of tint to it. It had a visual component. And when I was breathing in, I was watching all of the air come into my body. And then when I exhale, all the air is back in the room. And I see this. What ends up happening is that I stop trying to control the mechanism and I just let it do its thing, because I'm focusing on the air moving rather than how I'm moving the air. So that's one thing to keep in mind. We want to get out of our own way when it comes to the breathing. Another thing that's helpful in developing good breathing habits is going back to the idea of the Alexander technique. So in the Alexander technique, there's a thing called the primary control. And it's this idea, the crown of the head is floating up and slightly forward. After you get used to it a little bit and you practice breathing in this position, then everything starts to open up and you'll start to notice where you have tightness in your neck, in your chest, in your back, or whatever. You'll start to notice where you have tightness. So if you practice the primary control and then go back to the idea of breathing in the air from the room, then you're going to gain awareness of the muscles that are being used and where they're tight, where they're flexible. And just by developing that awareness, you're going to develop better breathing habits. You're going to develop more flexible breathing muscles. Your inhalation is going to become more effortless. Now, another thing that I found very helpful, once you have the idea of breathing in a more subconscious manner, Then you want to apply that same sensation with the mouthpiece on your chops like you're setting to play. The idea here is that a lot of times when people put this thing up to their face, they put the metal to the mouth, they start doing all this weird finagling. What ends up happening is that we're just creating excess tension in the embouchure that doesn't need to be there. And this, of course, is related to psychological tension as well. So all you do, put the mouthpiece on your chops. Same thing. Just imagine you're seeing the air coming in and get to where you can take that nice, same relaxed breath with the mouthpiece on your face. Super simple. The final step to this whole thing then is obviously adding the trumpet. To do that, rather than have the visual of the air around us entering the body, now we're going to start thinking more in terms of sound. G and the staff. Ba. Ba. What I'm going to do is imagine that the sound is already flowing forward, like I'm in a river of that sound, and the current is already flowing forward, and then I'm simply going to breathe in that sound and release it. So that's another way to take your mind off of the actual act of breathing and focus more on the end result, the sound you want to get. Now, some people will say, well, that's all well and good. I'm getting a nice relaxed breath on a G in the staff, but what about when I want to play high? Do I need to do any sort of additional compression or support and whatnot? It will require more tension down here in the lower torso abdomen when you're playing high to support the tone. But that's cool because you can learn it in exactly the same way as you learn how to play the G in the staff. Now I'm just gonna go an octave up. A little bit more support down here, but I'm not focusing on generating more tension. It's something that's happened habitually just from thinking about the sound, breathing in the sound, and letting it go. Good posture, nice floating posture. Research the primary control from the Alexander technique. From the primary control, practice your breathing and experiment with finding ways for you to not think about the breathing mechanism so much, but focus more on this idea of moving quantities of air. Apply that same feeling to the mouthpiece. Do a simple regimen, even just one note, and practice that a few times until you start to notice yourself relaxing a little bit and entering a better state for learning.